everyone, it's Laura from OurOilyHouse.com, and today I want to share with you guys a really simple recipe on how to make bath bombs. You've probably noticed that bath bombs are kind of the new thing. They're pretty much everywhere. I have bought a few at a farmer's market local to my house. I saw them at a booth at the fair. You can buy them at pretty much any type of like Bath and Body Works type store. And I knew they were something that a lot of people were making. And you would think me kind of being a DIYer and using a lot of essential oils and all these types of products that I would have made them before now. And they have been requested here on the YouTube channel several times, and I finally decided to just get the stuff and make them. And I realized that they're actually really simple to make. And so I'm excited to share this recipe with you. And if you have been kind of intimidated by the bath bomb making process, I'm gonna show you guys that it can actually be super simple. Okay, so the first thing you're gonna do is you're going to add in just 1 cup of baking soda into a medium to large size mixing bowl. And then we're going to add in 1/2 cup of citric acid, 1/2 cup cornstarch, and 1/4 cup of Epsom salt. And now we're just going to whisk these dry ingredients together into the bowl. And then we're going to add in our wet ingredients, which I have here 1/4 cup of coconut oil, and I already melted it and I measured it as it was melted. So it's 1/4 cup of melted coconut oil. And then I'm going to add in 1 teaspoon of vanilla. Now this is optional, and if you decide not to use the vanilla, you're just gonna add in some extra water here in the next step. But I think the vanilla adds a really calming and kind of nice touch to these bath bombs, and especially because today I'm using wild orange, and the wild orange and vanilla together really remind me of a dreamsicle, and I love that smell. So the next step is adding in your essential oils, and I'm just gonna do about 20 drops of wild orange. And you can do a blend of oils, you can do lavender, smells really good. That's another one that I really like in bath bombs. You can do a blend of citrus oils, wild orange, lemon, tangerine, all those would be good. You can do kind of a floral bath bomb by using some rose, jasmine, lavender, Roman chamomile, more calming. You can also make these bath bombs, let's say you wanna make one that would be good if you were dealing with any type of respiratory issue. You can make a bath bomb for that by adding together some eucalyptus and some peppermint. You can really get creative on this part. I'm going to whisk this together really well. And so over on the blog, I have a list of a few different bath bomb recipes and blends that you can use if you want some ideas. For the next step, we're going to take a spray bottle with some water in it, and you're just going to start misting your mixture here, and you're going to mix it up with your hands. You're gonna wanna make sure that you don't get this too wet, but you want your mixture to hold together in your hand without crumbling apart. So you're not gonna need very much water, but just start adding in a couple sprays at a time and then start mixing together. And as soon as your mixture starts holding its shape, then you know that it is ready for the next step. Now we are going to take some bath bomb molds, and I ordered these on Amazon, so I'll link them down in the description below so you can get these same ones if you want them. But I also saw over on Pinterest that you can make these with Easter eggs. So if you have some of those plastic Easter eggs that separate like this, you can actually make them in there. So I haven't tried that yet, but I'm excited to try that. You can also use a silicone mold that has many different shapes. You can make them in there. For the next step, we're going to take our bath bomb molds and we're going to put the mixture in both sides here. And then we're going to press them together. Push them down pretty hard, and then you can remove the excess of the powder onto the sides, and then take the top part off of your bath bomb, and you see it pulled its shape. And then we're just going to set this aside because we are gonna allow this to dry for our about 24 to 48 hours. You want it to be completely dry because that's gonna make it easier to pop the mold out and help it to hold its shape. So we're just gonna set it aside and I'm gonna continue to fill these. And this recipe makes about 5 bath bombs. These make really cute gifts to give for birthdays or Mother's Day or even Easter that's kind of coming up. If you guys are looking to get toxins out of your home, I have a free ebook that I have linked down in the description below with a few of my favorite home product recipes. And if you guys are looking for more essential oil education, I also have a free online class linked in the description below. And if this is your first time by my channel, I would love if you hit that subscribe button. I get out 2 new videos every single week on essential oil education, DIY recipes, and natural remedies for your home, health, and body. Thank you so much for stopping by our oily house.